viewers, and welcome to another edition of Open Heavens Reflections, where we reflect on the devotional written by Pastor E.A. Adeboye. My name is Andrea Onduku, and with my husband, Dr. Agbo Onduku, we pastor Chapel of Grace, which is a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God in Bradford in West Yorkshire. I'm happy to be with you today, and I know that as you watch today, you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Our topic today is true worship, and our Bible passage is taken from John 4, 21 to 24. Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when you will neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem worship the Father. You worship what you do not know. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. For the Father is seeking such to worship Him. God is spirit, and those who worship Him must worship in spirit and truth." Memory verse is verse 24 of John 4. God is spirit, and those who worship Him must worship in spirit and in truth. We are grateful to the Lord for the works and the words of edification that come from Pastor E.A. Adeboye every day, who is the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. The Lord, we have learned from today's topic, is seeking for those who would worship Him in spirit and in truth. God created us particularly to be able to worship Him. Revelation chapter 4 verse 11 states, "You are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they exist and were created." The Lord wants us to give Him praise at all times. The Lord does not accept the worship of sinners, so before you approach the throne, ensure that you are in right standing with the Lord. 1 John 1:6-9 says, "If we say that we have fellowship with Him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." We need to concentrate on the true worship of God and avoid sinful life in order to be able to worship our Maker. If you don't worship your Maker, then who are you supposed to worship? God wants us to come boldly to Him and not use any sort of gimmicks that can impede our relationship with Him. We should understand that as children of God, we have free access to His throne of grace. You can worship in your home, and you can also worship in church and in your place of worship. God desires our praises at all times. He wants us to acknowledge Him as the Lord of our lives. It is also important to understand that there is nothing we really do for the Lord without the help of the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit in order to meet the requirements of God in every area of our lives. Again, this is another area where God can teach you how to worship. The Holy Spirit is able to teach you how to worship Him. And so if you are not sure how you should worship, remember that our Bible passage told us that God is spirit, and we must therefore worship Him in spirit and in truth. So ask the Holy Spirit to show you today how to worship Him in spirit and in truth. Our action point today tells us to read Galatians 5:19-23. Identify the works of the flesh still manifesting in your life and pray for power to live above them. And as you do that, I know He will empower you in Jesus' name. Thank you so much for watching today. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.